I'm Trevor Alonso. Let's talk about the world of Jingle All the Way. Yes, the Arnold Schwarzenegger Christmas movie. No, not that one. That one. Okay, this isn't a review. I'm gonna talk about how there's a few odd things in this, and it seems like it's a completely different world. It's a little hard to believe that he doesn't know that his son is into Turbo Man. Like in a scene when he asks his son what he wants for Christmas, and he's completely surprised by it when you can see a bunch of Turbo Man stuff in the room. With my kids, I'm pretty sure I know what they're into, especially if we decorate the room or have stuff in the room with that character, or they're always watching that show. And also, most kids want to watch their favorite show with their parents. So is Arnold like coming home and he's like, hey, what do you want to watch? When he spends time with his son, and his son says Turbo Man, and he's like, whatever. Star Wars cartoons and Paw Patrol are almost on TV all the time at my house. Now, the way everybody's shopping and stuff on the last day is kind of like our world, but it also seems like time is really different, or how early are these shops opening, because Arnold is able to go to all these stores' openings and get to the parade on time. And what time is the parade? Like, usually parades are like at 9 or 10 in the morning. Also, Sinbad is a mailman, apparently carrying around packages. So, there's a lot of people that day that are not getting their mail. And that's on Christmas Eve. He seems like a really irresponsible mailman. And on top of that, one of those packages has a bomb. So when you think about it, he's running around being pushed and shoved and knocking people over while carrying a bomb. Granted, when it does go off, it seems like a cartoon scene where everybody just has like charcoal all over their face. But jeez, that could have gone off in a mall. Now, here's where it really seems like it takes place in a different world or something, because at one point when Arnold actually gets in a fight with a reindeer, the reindeer seems like it's talking. And especially when we get to the parade. Arnold takes the wrong turn and somehow ends up in a place where they're putting on a Turbo Man suit onto him. So, there's another guy that has his exact same measurements. No, wait, there's actually two guys with his exact same measurements, because they said like another guy got burned and they're expecting a replacement, and then Arnold just walked in. So that's a pretty big coincidence of three guys with the same size. And not only that, but they put a jetpack on him. It's an actual working jetpack. Majority of this movie is pretty grounded until it gets to the jetpack. I kind of feel like the suspension of disbelief should have started early on. As a kid, I didn't mind it, and maybe because I was with my family and it's Christmas, we're already having fun. But looking back, it's really late in the game to add a sci-fi element. Now granted, there are real jetpacks in real life, but they're more like the James Bond jetpack where you actually have to walk into it, strap it on, and it takes you like 50 feet. And this is like a full-on superhero jetpack where like the controllers come in and out. I mean, it's almost like a Mandalorian jetpack. And on top of that, he's never worked the jetpack and he works it right away like he knows it's actually gonna fly, when in real life you would be thinking, well, I better run up there to save my son. It's not like I can actually fly. And for a lot of people, the jetpack kind of throws off the whole movie. Now, despite the jetpack, I still enjoy the movie and it's still fun to watch. And there is part of you that thinks, man, that kid gave up the action figure when the whole point of the movie was getting that. Though part of it was like, it's my dad. I love him. And he doesn't need it because he has the real Turbo Man. Though in real life when he gave up the toy, that seems like there would be an evidence, because this is all a crime, because clearly Sinbad tried to hurt this kid in front of all these people. Also, it's Christmas Eve and they didn't take care of the toy sooner. Now granted, his wife did say she mentioned it to him early on, but why didn't she bring it up multiple times? And on top of that, when he thought, oh yeah, I gotta get my kid a gift, I gotta get my wife a gift, because it ends with him going, uh-oh, I didn't get her a gift. Which at that point, on Christmas Eve evening, what is he gonna do? Now, on a side note, they were trying to actually make Turbo Man into an actual thing. the filmmakers were like, oh yeah, we have Arnold, and we're gonna put him in a superhero suit. This will be great. And they made actual Turbo Man action figures that Christmas and like the following year. It's like they were hoping that this would be like kind of a backdoor pilot for either a Turbo Man series or movie or something. But that didn't happen. With all that being said, I still enjoyed the movie. And I still try to watch it every Christmas. Thank you for watching my video.